Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you're going to learn how to track people as they navigate between different websites using cross-domain tracking. I'm going to show you how you can set up cross-domain tracking using Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics. If you don't set up cross-domain tracking, then you'll see a new session reported as someone travels from your first website to your second website. And you'll also see the first website show up in your acquisition reports. This can be a real problem if you expect people to convert on your second website. Let's get started. We're going to be implementing cross-domain tracking on my two test domains. So we're going to track people as they navigate between lovesdatatest.com and lovesdatatest2.com. Let's start by looking at what happens if we don't implement cross-domain tracking. When we open the first domain, we'll see we have a user reported inside Google Analytics. We can navigate to the real-time reports to see this. So here we can see we have a single user reported. Now let's go back to the website and let's navigate to the second domain. Now let's take a look at the real-time reports again. We can now see that we have two users reported. Both domains have the same Google Tag Manager container and the same Google Analytics tracking code, but Google Analytics is seeing me as two separate users. So what we need to do is configure cross-domain tracking so that we get accurate data in our reports. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to do this. Now I'm guessing you're already using Google Tag Manager to deploy Google Analytics on your website. So here we can see there is an existing Google Analytics tag. So let's select the tag to edit it. Now we just need to make a few modifications to the tag. The first thing we need to do is select the option to enable overriding settings. This gives us access to additional configurations we can make to the tag. Now we're going to select More Settings, then Fields to Set, and click Add Field. We need to enter Allow Linker as the field name and True as the value. This tells the Google Analytics tracking code that we want to automatically modify links on our website so that when people click them, it will synchronize the Google Analytics cookie on the other website. Now we need to add another field. And we're going to enter Cookie Domain and then Auto. This tells Google Analytics to automatically choose a cookie domain to use when we track users. Scrolling down, we need to look for cross-domain tracking, and in the Auto Link Domains field, we need to enter the domains we want to track. For our example, we're going to enter lovesdatatest.com, lovesdatatest2.com. This tells Google Analytics these are the domains we want to use for cross-domain tracking. I've entered this directly into the field, but if you're likely to reuse this value in another tag inside Google Tag Manager, you could create a new variable with the value instead. Now, since I also have a form that submits between the two domains that I also want to track, I'm going to set Decorate Forms to True. This allows you to automatically track form submissions across domains. That's it. Now I'm going to save my tag and publish the container. Let's travel back to the website and refresh the page. Now let's head to Google Analytics. And we can see our user reported in the real-time reports. Now let's head back to the website. And let's click the link to the second domain. You'll notice in the browser's URL bar there are some additional characters. This is how Google Analytics synchronizes cookies for our users between the two domains. It passes the cookie value, which is our unique identifier, the client ID, to the other website. This is then seen by Google Analytics and used to understand it's the same user traveling between the domains. Now let's head back to Google Analytics. We can now see that a second page view has been reported, but our user count is still one. This means we've successfully configured cross-domain tracking. So that's how you can set up cross-domain tracking using Google Tag Manager. You'll now be able to see the original acquisition source, even if people navigate between your two websites. Are you using cross-domain tracking with Google Analytics? I'd love to know. Let me know and leave your tips in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.